Shush, starring Rebecca Front as Alice and Morwenna Banks as Snoo. Also starring Ben Wilbond as Simon and Michael Fenton-Stevens as Dr. Cadogan. This week, Top Shelf.
Welcome to Woodgrove Library. Can I help you?
Yes. What's the Wi-Fi password?
Oh, it's library.
Thank you.
Oh, but not the usual spelling. I live in fear of being hacked. Well, I live in fear of just about everything, but being hacked sounds particularly unpleasant. So, it's L-I, two B's, an asterisk, three R's, one with a cedilla. A.
A.
I said one with a cedilla.
No, I was confirming the A.
Oh, I see.
O, I, C.
No. You've gone awry. There is an I, but no O or C.
Right.
Then it's another A.
Yeah.
And another.
Mm-hmm.
And another, but upside down. No second R. And that's it.
Why?
Why what?
Is there a Y?
Oh, no, that would be too easy to guess.
Right. Oh, Alice, I'm so sorry. I've been gone ages.
Snoo, what took you so long? I was beginning to worry.
Oh, there was a queue at the sandwich shop as long as me arm.
Right. Hang on, Snoo. I'm sure you told me your arms are rather short.
When did I tell you that?
At your interview, you said short arms were an asset for a librarian.
Did I? Mm,
because you can reach things on low shelves. Customer Snoo, your turn.
Oh, OK. Hi, I'm looking for a suitable boy.
I beg your pardon.
I'm off on holiday tomorrow and I'll need some stimulation by the pool.
Oh, will you now?
And I'm there for 3 weeks, so the bigger the better.
Oi, sling your hook. This is a library, not an escort agency. Out!
Oh.
God, some people.
FY information, Snoo. A Suitable Boy is a novel by Vikram Seth.
Oh.
I mean, it just might be a good idea, given that this is a library, if your default assumption were to be this person's looking for a book.
Right, yep, yep. Okay, okay.
We don't want a repeat of the Moby Dick incident.
No, point taken, Alice. I tell you what, I'll start putting these new arrivals away. Right, now, where does this one go?
What is it?
It's Will Self's latest.
A novel.
Remind me, a novel's the one that's
not real.
Okay, in that case, no, he's giving health advice to middle-aged men.
Oh, then we file it under Will Self Self-Help Health.
Okay, where's that?
On the Will Self Self-Help Health shelf.
Have we got a Will Self Self-Help Health shelf?
We've got a Will Self Self-Help Wealth shelf and a Will Self Self-Help Stealth shelf.
A Will Self Self-Help Stealth shelf? Where's that then?
Oh, hiding somewhere.
Or we could just file it with the other books with blue covers.
Yes, let's do that, actually. Excellent work, Snoo.
Yay! Go us!
Do you mind? I'm trying to fill out this form. Woodgrove Library is at the cutting edge of technology. Oh, biro snapped.
So what's the form for?
We talked about this earlier.
Oh, did we? Honestly, I've got a 2-second memory. In my last job, they used to call me Snoo the Fish.
Did they?
Did they what?
Well, the council have asked us to detail what we offer to the local community.
Oh, is it for, like, a best library competition?
I think it must be. At first, I thought maybe they were going to use it to shut us down, but then I thought, don't be ridiculous, Alice. It's a library. Free books for all. You'd have to be an idiot to shut that down.
Right, go on then, read it out.
Right. Question one. Would your library make a good branch of Home Base? What a curious thing to ask.
Oh, well, we could make space for compost and barbecue tongs by the front door. Yes, I put down yes.
Go on.
Right, next question.
Do you provide an efficient service?
Oh, hang on, here's another customer.
Oh, hello there. Do you have any books by famous authors about blue and white Dutch pottery?
We do indeed, sir, over there on the Will Sell Self-Help Delft shelf.
Oh, thank you. What a very efficient service.
Oh, you see, Alice, I think we could be in with a chance of winning this best library competition. So what do you get if you win?
Doesn't say.
Oh, a surprise, even better. I love surprises, don't you? My husband was always surprising me.
Oh, what sort of surprises?
Oh, breakfast in bed, flowers, getting off with my best friend.
Snoo, I'm so sorry. You never mentioned you had a husband.
Well, I don't, not anymore.
Right. Well, anyway, to answer your earlier question, surprises are my worst nightmare, apart from being buried alive and speaking in public, or being buried alive in public while speaking as a surprise.
Oh, you've got to conquer all these phobias, Alice.
I am trying.
You know, in your head, the whole world is as scary as this book with a picture of a zombie on the cover.
Yes, I thought we were going to file that with the other Will Self books. But you're right, of course. I have nothing to fear but fear itself. And open spaces, and closed spaces, and lifts, trains, buses, boats, bikes, planes, people, dogs, heights. Oh, and penises. I said penises, I meant penises. Pencils!
You're scared of pencils?
Only the extendable ones with rubbers on the end.
You're definitely talking
definitely
about...
Definitely pencils, yes.
Morning, all.
Oh, hello, Dr. Cadogan.
Ah, the bells of the bookshelves. A very good day to you.
Morning, Dr. Cadogan.
Hilary, please.
No, my name's Snoo, you know that.
No, my name's Hilary.
Oh, I thought Hilary was a girl's name.
Nothing girly about me, Snoo. Nothing feminine about Hilary Leslie Jessica Duggan.
So what can we do for you today, Doctor? Is your secretary still in Machu Picchu?
Yes, lovely Araminta. She says you won't be coming back. I'm distraught. She was the best unpaid intern money didn't have to buy. Anywho, in the absence of dear Minty, I wondered if you could continue to help me with my photocopying.
Of course, Doctor. You've got illustrious lives to save.
Indeed I do.
So, which of your celebrity patients will you be examining today?
Well, strictly entre nous, David Dimbleby.
Oh, I like him. He's got a ruggedly handsome face.
Yes. Skin like the bark of a 300-year-old oak tree. But when you kiss it, it's remarkably soft. So, ladies, can I leave this photocopying in your capable hands?
Good Lord, what is all this? Intimate maladies and down-below disorders of the rich and famous.
Are you writing a book?
I like to think of it more as an insurance policy.
For when you retire?
Or get... struck off. Again. I'll pop back to it later, assuming they haven't closed you down.
Closed us down?
We're actually in line to win a prestigious library prize. We've just filled out the application form.
Oh, dear, you haven't heard. I hate to be a tittle-tattle, but I had the chair of the library committee in the stirrups yesterday. He said he was staring into an enormous black hole. So I offered to adjust the stirrups, but it turned out he meant the budget deficit.
Oh, my goodness.
Anyway, I recommended a regime of crack inspections, which he thought might also work for the libraries.
So a library inspector might just turn up unannounced?
Indeed, yes. Sorry, mustache. Poor old David Starkey needs lancing. He's become very puffed up. Toodle-pip.
Snoo, this is appalling.
I know. Have you seen some of the pictures in Dr. Cadogan's insurance policy book?
No, I'm talking about what he just said.
Oh, that? Yeah, appalling. Terrible. Sorry, just remind me what it was again.
Now, Snoo.
Yeah.
This library inspector will be masquerading as an ordinary customer, so watch out for anyone saying, "Excuse me, can you help me?"
Excuse me, can you help me?
Yes, one moment. I'm just briefing my colleague. Treat everyone with the utmost suspicion.
Excuse me.
Bear with me, please. The thing is, I need this job.
If I could just...
1 second! It's my escape route from Daddy. I have to prove to him that I can survive in the outside world.
You're agoraphobic. You can't survive in the outside world.
I can survive on the inside of the outside world.
Excuse me.
I'm actually still talking, thank you. What would you do if we had to close down?
Oh, well, I've got a plan B. I've always wanted to get a job as Kate Moss.
I'm not sure, but I think Kate Moss already has that job.
Typical, it's who you know, isn't it?
Right, I'm not waiting any longer. I want to return this book and renew this one.
Aren't we forgetting the magic word?
I want to return this book and renew this one, please.
I should think so.
Alice, don't get into one of your stressy fits.
Now, say that again. It's terribly confusing. This one out and this one in.
No, this one out, this one in.
That's exactly what I said.
But you were pointing at different books.
Why is that relevant?
Because that's the one I want to return.
Have you read it?
No, not all of it.
Well, in that case, you need to renew it so you have longer to read it.
But I'm not enjoying it. I want to leave it here.
Oh. You want to leave the substandard book for us to deal with?
Yes.
And keep the successful book at home with you where nobody else can get a look in?
Well, I think so.
You need to take a long, hard look at yourself.
Could you just stamp it out for me, please?
Yes, of course. Where's the stamp? Right? Stamp, 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 stamp.
Alice, you might need to go and do some of your special breathing.
Yes, I think I should take a moment. Maybe I'll make a start on Dr. Cadogan's photocopy.
I'm not sure that's going to calm you down. Oh, I am sorry about that, sir. My colleague gets a little bit hot and bothered.
Could be to do with that strange thing she's wearing.
What, the neck-to-ankle Hessian poncho?
Yes. What is that? A religious thing? I mean, is she a little Amish?
No, that's me, but it helps with the low shelves.
Right. Well, perhaps you could help me with something. I'm looking for Brick Lane by Monica Alley.
Okie doke, bear with me.
It's nice to see there's one competent librarian here. Sorry, why are you looking at an A to Z?
Okay, I found Brick Lane. But it's nowhere near Monica Alley.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.